Hey guys, I hope you're all well. I'm starting off the vlog today in a little bit of a rush. I've got to make my train in the next 10 minutes or so. So I'm in a little bit of a rush just to get ready, but I'm pretty much there. I'm just gonna grab all my stuff, grab my water bottle because water bottle is essential on the train. I have a few meetings today and I also have a work lunch, which I really cannot wait to bring you along to. I'm heading to the Montague Kitchen today to review the lunch menu there. Super excited to bring you along. I'm also going to be posting some content on social media, so that's kind of why I'm here. I'm also going to be doing this vlog today, so you guys will see everything surrounding the Hyatt and also the church. So you guys will see everything inside the of course I'm going to be vlogging and bringing you along so you guys can see and experience the Montague Kitchen for yourself. I definitely recommend that you go there. I've been there before and I absolutely loved it previously, but I've not actually been there for lunch, so this is going to be a really nice new experience. I'm also going to be meeting my journalist friend Neil, who has come with me to lots of different things. He's also invited me, bless him, to other events and things for his own reviews, because he is a food writer. I'm going to link him below in case you want to check him out. But yeah, it's going to be really nice to catch up. I haven't seen him since before Christmas, or like way before Christmas. I feel like the last time I saw him, it was sunny outside and we were sitting outside. So yeah, it's been a long time, but it's going to be nice just to catch up and just kind of chat about all things journalism, what's going on in the industry, and just have a proper catch up. So I just wanted to start the vlog off here because it's nicer, I think, when I do a little bit of an introduction, even though I'm in a mad rush. But please stick around, subscribe if you're new, and enjoy the vlog. Hi guys, I'm here with the lovely Lucy. Say hello. I'll tag your at on the screen. We're having a lovely morning meeting.
We've got lots to catch up on.
We do. We're talking about the podcast, yeah.
We've got big things coming on the podcast.
Definitely. Also London Fashion Week plans that we've got to iron out.
Yes. Oh my gosh, stay tuned guys, it's a busy week.
It's a busy it's week, so we're getting the fuel now.
Yeah, we've got to have that almond
croissant.
Fuel.
Yeah, I've gone for an iced latte, which looks delish. And we're just going to sit here, catch up, and chat all things London Fashion Week. Hey guys, so I have had my morning meeting with Lucy and we ended up just having breakfast at Gale's Bakery in Soho. I'm now in the Hyatt Regency Hotel in London and I'm about to have my lunch meeting at the Montague. I thought I would just freshen up because my hair has been so windswept. I actually haven't brushed my hair yet, so I need to do that and also chop up my lipstick and then head to my little meeting, which is literally in this hotel. So yeah, I love it when a hotel has a nice bathroom because it means I can just do my makeup in peace and just freshen up before I go for my meeting. It's always nice just to feel like fully together. I never like going into a meeting feeling and looking windswept. But yeah, I think there's a storm coming or something, or there is a storm because it's so windy outside. But yeah, today is gonna be a nice, like, pretty much just leisurely meeting day. Tomorrow I've actually just had the go ahead for a few other events, so tomorrow's daily vlog is going to be super exciting as well. I'm going to do lots of little daily vlogs just because I think it's going to be easier to break up all the different days. I'm then also going to be meeting Sadie and going to dinner with Sadie for another press review, so lots of food and drink and events coming up for you guys in all these videos, but I really hope you enjoy. Yeah, this is my look and I'm just going to get myself ready and freshened up.
Love the way my hair goes when I use my Revlon hot brush. Just the texture of my hair just stays so much silkier than when I straighten it. Oh, I feel a bit like Carrie Mulligan right now. Just need some like little clips, and also is it Gwyneth Paltrow where she has the little clips in her hair in the fur coat? lip gloss. Which is the Maybelline Lifter Gloss Obsessed. And then to finish, a little spritz of perfume. Because I feel like the tube just sticks to you, the smell. I'm gonna have a little sip.
Bitter leaves, the sweet and the caramel cooks, and then obviously the acidity in your normal kind of artichoke that's cooked like farigosa style. So we hope that will be a fantastic kind of a bit more than just a goat cheese.
Gotta be done by a food writer. Epic. This is the Clementine chocolate bar. Is that solid chocolate?
It's really dense.
Oh my goodness me. How are we going to tackle this?
That was a lot more work than I thought it was going to be.
Okay guys, so I am back home now and back from the review. Very, very stuffed, I have to say. But made it home eventually after having my train cancelled, which was a bit of a palaver. But we're home now. It's super windy outside as well. I feel like there's a storm happening today or like over the next few days, which is just going to add to the craziness that is the next few days and London Fashion Week. My door is also shaking. I'm trying to make it less noisy, but it's just so super windy, you can probably hear it. I thought I would just finish off this vlog with a small unboxing. I've got some deliveries. So I've got a delivery from Brand Nation for some bits that I'm going to feature maybe in tomorrow's vlog, depending on how organized I can be tomorrow morning. If not, I will talk about it at some point in one of these videos. It might even be one of the next vlogs coming along, depending on when I can do it. But I'll at least show you the products today and show you what the vibe is. I've also had, and I'm so excited to show you, a delivery for my business cards. I've never ordered from Moo before, but they have arrived and I'm just, oh my God, I'm so excited to show you. So maybe I'll show you that first. But yeah, I'm super excited. Actually, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do it last just because I'm excited to see what they're looking like. And I don't know, it feels like it's building the suspense up. But I thought I would just show you a couple of pieces of PR that I received. And actually, there are two things that I love so much. So, maybe this isn't it actually. Oops. Okay. This is the removal cream. Damn. Okay, so I thought it was going to be the wax strips, but it's the facial hair removal kit, which I've not actually tried this properly, so I'll let you guys know how I get on. But one thing that I've been using is the Jolene, I don't know, but they have a wax strip, which I rely on for my sideburns. I literally have sideburns, guys, it's crazy. But the little bit of fluff here, like you can probably see, I get like a tuft of hair that just grows. Normally I wax it with the wax strips, but I don't know how this is gonna fare, whether this is gonna make things worse or not. So we'll see. It says facial hair remover. So I don't know.
it might work. I'm gonna give it a go. I obviously don't want to trigger the hair to grow too crazy, but we're just gonna see how it goes. I'll do maybe like a little patch test. But the other thing that I received, which I'm super excited about because I haven't had a chance to whiten my teeth in so long, is some new whitening strips. These are the Glow 32 strips. I switched between these ones and the Beverly Hills Formula ones, the white strips. Absolutely love both. These ones have a coconut taste, so if you are not a fan of coconut, it might not be for you. But yeah, I'm super excited to be able to whiten my teeth. I'm going to do that tonight. I'm also going to fake tan tonight because the next few days are so super busy for me and I just need to look good. So that's why I've had my nails done. It's why I'm just pampering myself, getting myself ready to go. The next few days, like, you can literally tell by my energy just how chaotic everything is. But super excited to just pamper myself a little bit. Glad I've got my nails done. Probably TMI, but I had a wax done recently, which I don't know what it is. But when I get a wax done, I feel like I am the bee's knees. I don't know what it is. I can't quite put my finger on it. No one's seeing down there. But for me, it just makes me feel like my life is together. And I feel like, oh, just, I feel like anything can happen. I feel like I am me when the hair is gone. Yeah, it is TMI. I'm sorry, guys, but it's a confidence boost. I'm really considering getting laser hair removal. It's something that I'm seriously looking into because I'm just fed up of it and I don't want to have to wax all the time and also let the hair grow out. That's the most annoying bit, like actually letting the hair grow out. So yeah, I need to get on that ASAP. But the problem is summer is coming up now, so it would be too risky to do it now. So I'm gonna probably have to wait till like September time, start the process then, get myself hair free. I might even go the whole shebang and do like my arms and my legs and my underarms and everything. But yeah, anyway, that's a conversation for a different day. PR packages aside, super happy with those and gonna give those a go. Let's have a look at these business cards because I've never ordered from Moo before and they've arrived looking pretty jazzy in two boxes. Ooh, I'm excited. It says start networking quick, your business cards are here. I have to say the process has been pretty good. Oh, that's a little stamp. Ooh. Oh my god. Okay guys, I actually know now why these were so expensive. They're small. Hopefully it's gonna focus. I decided to go for this image. I took, I believe it was the Asish Spring Summer 19, I think. The Spring Summer 19 show. And it's one of my photos. I just thought a little action shot of the model walking past would be super cool and edgy. And then I'm just gonna have to cover up my phone number just because I don't want loads of random people calling me. You guys can email me though. That's what the business card looks like on the other side. My phone number is obviously below here, but I really love that. It's simple. And I decided to go for vertical because I don't normally do vertical. But that's quite jazzy. I'm actually quite impressed with that. I actually really like that. Let's go a bit closer. I feel like it just wants to focus on my face. There we go. So that's my business card, guys. Really happy with that. I'm so glad they arrived in time because from tomorrow I've got so many events and I just want to give my card out. I've got really big people, like important people that I need to impress the next few days. And I had business cards, but they were just like not on brand at all. My photography ones, I haven't redone since 2018. And it was when I didn't really know where I was going photography wise. So it was just like a black and white picture. I think of like a rose. Like, what does that even mean? It doesn't represent my branding. It doesn't represent what I do. It's got nothing to do with me. I think it had like my old email in it that wasn't even a photography email. So yeah, it was really like stripped back and messy. But what did I say in the podcast about just taking messy action? Sometimes it has to be done in order to get progress. And it was a chapter and a part of my life. I'm not going to shame myself for what I created back then when I didn't know what I know now, but that's the beauty of growth and that's the beauty of developing your skill and just working out what you want to do. So yeah, I'm really super excited for the next few days. I can't believe the things that are happening. I'm just feeling a little bit surreal. I've also just had confirmation as well that on Sunday I am going to be staying in a hotel which is literally on or just around the corner from the Strand, which is really exciting, and it's going to be gifted. I'm so super excited to be staying there. More on that when I touch on that vlog. I feel like that will be like 2 vlogs time or maybe 3 vlogs time. I don't know, there's so much going on in the next few days. I literally can't believe it, but I'm gonna try not to be too chaotic. I'm just super excited and I need to get myself organized. So yeah, tonight I will just be going through getting my pictures scheduled for the next few days, because I'm going to be so busy I won't have time to look at my phone or be on my phone. Get myself ready and fake tanned. I'm going to do a bit of a teeth whitening moment, get myself feeling fresh. What else do I need to do? I need to edit a vlog. I also need to schedule and post tonight some content from the Montague kitchen. The food was fantastic. I actually really enjoyed it. Got to chat with the chef as well. And can I just say as well, there was a dish which was featured earlier. Sorry, my brain is so scattered. I featured it in one of the clips. It was one of the dishes for the dinner menu. And oh my goodness, it was an artichoke dish. Phenomenal. It wasn't vegan, but we're just gonna forget about that for a moment. It was incredible. It has got honey in it, so if you're vegan, you can't have it, but maybe they might be able to do something with the carve or something, I don't know. They might be able to veganize it. Anyway, it was incredible. Probably the best dish out of everything that I had, and it was such a small, subtle contribution of flavors. Contribution? Is that the right word? I don't know. Kind of combination. That's what I mean, not contribution. Combination of flavours. It just tasted amazing. Both me and Neil said that as well. And yeah, it's really nice when dishes are really unsuspecting, but actually are the most memorable. I think that's a sign of a really good chef. And yeah, we were just sort of chatting away about the seasonality of the menu and what's available. It's a really relaxed vibe, and also it's a hotel as well, so if you're staying there, super chilled, very easy to kind of enjoy. That they've got the Churchill Bar as well, Churchill Bar and Terrace, which I think is a bit sort of cigar-y, a bit sexy, and I think it's still going. I think it is. It's just round the corner from the restaurant. And that's kind of like cocktails and stuff. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. So grateful and thankful for the chance to review it. That's going to be going up online once it is online. And there's a link. I'll pop it in the description for you guys to check out and read. If you want to read my articles, that would mean the world. But yeah, it's a bit of a mixed bag in the next few days. I'm shooting photography. I'm attending events as an influencer. And I'm also writing reviews. So yeah, it's where all my sort of branding and just me as a whole come together. So it's going to be super exciting. But I thought I would just end the vlog here and say thank you so much for tuning in. I really hope it's been a nice little vlog and London vlog. The next few vlogs are all going to be London vlogs. But there's lots going on. So super excited. But yeah, I will see you guys in my next video, which is very soon. So enjoy.
things. I've been driving this train, years in this lane. There's no stopping this flame, cause I came to the game and I changed it to play how I like, rearranged it to my own domain. Yeah, I got what it takes, made lots of mistakes, taking